I wanna be the very best, like no one ever was. Dun, dun, dun. To catch them is my real test, to train them is my cause. Hello everyone, I'm Karen and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to do the Pokemon Go tag. This tag was originally taken from Read at Midnight and I was tagged by Xena, and I'll have all the information down below. I'm a little bit Pokemon obsessed at the moment. I didn't know I could put Pokemon Go on my phone because I thought I didn't have enough space, and then it turns out I do, and now I just can't stop it. Anyway, we're going to do a book tag based on Pokemon, so. First question is Start Pokemon. Which book started your love of reading? And I don't really remember. I do remember when I was in primary school, we had these like graded groups of reading and I went through them so fast. So I really loved that, but I think the first book I really remember, and I remember the title of, is Journey of the Shadowbands by, I think, is it Margaret J. Anderson? But it's called Operation Canada in Dutch, and I have a copy of it back home, and it was one of my very first books I got given as a present, and I treasure it to this day. I really loved it. Plus, Elspeth, the main character, she's such a badass. She basically goes, oh, everybody's gone. I'm just gonna go to Canada with my younger brother and save the day. Question number two is Pikachu, an iconic classic that you'll always love. And for this, I pick Harry Potter. Do I need to elaborate? Number three is Zubat, a book you lost interest in because it was everywhere. Now, I didn't exactly lose interest into this book, but it did take me quite a couple of months to read The Wrath and the Dawn. I'd had it for like 2 or 3 months before I even read it. But I think it was also because it was everywhere and everybody was so raving about it, and I felt kind of intimidated by it. I don't even know why, don't ask me, but yeah, I love this book now, so I'm very happy that I didn't give up on it. Question number four is Ditto, a book that reminds you of countless others, but that you love anyways. And for this one, I pick The Serpent King by Jeff Zentner. Now, a small town and teenagers trying to find their way in the world has been done a million times before. But the way that Jeff Zentner did it in this book just really spoke to me. His characters are so relatable. So I just, yeah, he does it really well. Question number five is Snorlax, a book or series that you still have to start because of its size. Now, as you know, I love big books and I cannot lie. And I read tons of Brandon Sanderson, but I still haven't read The Name of the Wind by Patrick Rothfuss. I don't know why, I just haven't, okay? I think I do feel quite intimidated, but I think it's more just by the book in general rather than just the size. But I will get to it, it is on my Kindle. So there's hope for the future, I think. Question number six is Gengar, a book that kept you up all night, and there's a million books that have done that to me because I am the queen of starting a book and then wanting to finish it. And then I finish it in the middle of the night and I'm a zombie for the next 2 days. But the one book that I will always remember doing that for is Golden Sun by Pierce Brown. I finished it at, say, about 2 in the morning and I was crying like a maniac. And basically Dean woke up next to me and he was like, are you okay? And I just went, you don't understand. So yeah, this is definitely the top Gengar book for me. Question number seven is Nido King and Nido Queen, your favorite bookish OTP. Can I just say me and all the books? No, is that cheating? Anyway, if I really have to choose, one of the couples I've been loving lately is Vala and Aldrich from the Air Awaken series. There's just something about them. I love the whole push and pull thing. Just drives me crazy, but I enjoy it at the same time. So why do you make me choose? I don't want to choose. I don't like choosing. Question number eight is Rapidash, a book that flew by for you. It's hot, it's awesome, it's really cool, and it's Never Night by Jay Kristoff. I'm not even sorry. This is gonna be in every single video I do probably from now until next year. Maybe. Zero fucks given, really. Question number nine is Eevee, a series or a book that you will never tire of seeing spin-offs from, and I think this is gonna be the Grisha trilogy by Leigh Bardugo. I haven't read Six of Crows yet, but I just can't wait to read it and read Crooked Kingdom, and I love this world, so yeah. Magical Russian inspired worlds just kinda float my boat. Number 10 is Magikarp, a series that was surprisingly awesome, and for me that was Air Awakens by Eliza Kova. I thought it was gonna be good because lots of people were raving, but it was so good. I didn't expect to love it as much as I do, so I still need to read the fourth book, but I am so scared after I read Earth's End, so I don't know when that's gonna happen, but it will because I need to finish. somebody help me. Number 11 is Legendary Pokemon, a book or a series that's kind of overhyped or everywhere, but that you're still really excited to read, and for me, it's Throne of Glass. I just like the series, and I want to continue, and I want to figure out what's going to happen to all of my favorite characters, so somebody will have to hold me, I think, after Empire of Storms, because I have a very bad feeling about that book. A very bad feeling. Number 12 is Mew or Mewtwo, a collector's edition that you wish you owned, and I just really want the Six of Crows Crooked Kingdom box set when it comes out. It looks amazing. I love stained pages. I already have Six of Crows, so I probably won't be able to get the box set, but I really want it, people! Somebody just get it for my birthday. Please? Question number 13 is a Poke Egg, a debut novel that you're super excited for, and this, for me, will come as no surprise because it's Caraval by Stephanie Garber. I've been trying like a maniac to get an advanced reader copy while I was at YALC, and I did manage it, and I just want to read it. It sounds like the kind of book that is like made for me. Like, it just yes. I also just got like a look at the map from it, and it has a map. You people, yes. Please, somebody, powers that be, get me a copy ASAP, please. Question number 14 is Allure Model, an autobi author. I have quite a few of those. Don't make me choose. Brandon Sanderson, Sarah J Maas, probably Lee Bardugo by now, Maggie Stiefvater, and now, most recently, Jay Kristoff, because holy bejesus, I need to read everything he writes. And finally, question 15 is The Server Is Down, which is a book release you've been waiting on forever. Well, Caraval, you know, Caraval, but if I can't choose the same thing, then I would say the third book in the Stormlight Archive by Brandon Sanderson. Now, I know those books are huge and they probably take a long time to write, but I just want to read it so badly. I think I'm going to do like a Way of Kings and a Words of Radiance reread anytime soon because I miss that world. It's so wonderful. So there you have it. That was my Pokemon book tag. So which release are you dying for? Just tell me down below because I need to commiserate with somebody. I've been waiting so long for that Brandon Sanderson book. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and I'll talk to you all very soon. Bye.